Joining me now from Southern California, senior pastor at Calvary Chapel, Chino Hills, California, Jack Hibbs. Pastor Jack, when I see an attack on a church like this, it to me is tantamount to attack on God. But when you step back and you look at the rioting and this kind of behavior in various cities, and then you couple it with the government response to the Wuhan coronavirus, deeming churches, aka God, non-essential, it seems to me that church, i.e. God, is more essential, beyond essential, more than ever right now.
Well, Graham, we're starting to see a decline of our culture that is literally the result of us as a nation banning God from the courts, banning God from the schools, removing the Bible from the presence of our civil discourse. And now we throw our hands up and we wonder, why is this happening? This is exactly the historical outcome where you have on Pentecost Sunday, militants acting up as they have and targeting churches. This is where we as Americans need to get back to defending our nation and get back to our Judeo-Christian values. It's those values that kept us stable. But Graham, you know well, you report on it well, that we're losing our ancient mooring, and we're going to descend down unless something happens, and we need to return back to that, the fact that God's got the answer. Jesus Christ is our hope. And these targets are very well specifically picked out and selected, certainly on Pentecost Sunday.
Too many have lost our religion, their religion in this country. Poll after poll after poll, we see people participating in formalized religion in this country dropping, plummeting down. Question is, Pastor Jack, without going into too deep, how do we get them back? How do we get people back? It seems to me one of the routes to get people back to our Judeo-Christian foundation is to underline the constitutional foundation of this republic and look no further than the First Amendment of the United States, which protects religion and the reason behind it being Amendment Number 1.
Yeah, absolutely. First Amendment, with all due respect, doesn't apply to Costco or Walmart. It applies to the church and the press, and for us American citizens to gather freely. And we're protected by that. Having said that, to get back, what we need to do, we need to get back as churches to teaching the Bible. The Bible's the answer. People need to hear it again. They need to see it, by the way, alive and living. Not some entertainment, not some amusement park type of Christianity, but about the cross, about the resurrection of Jesus, that God will give us direction. This is the foundation of our country.
We've got to take a stand, and this may be the moment in time to take a stand. Now, you took a stand on Sunday, Pentecost Sunday, along with hundreds of other churches in California, and I believe thousands of other churches across the country, and you said, hey, you know what? We understand about this pandemic. We understand about the virus. We understand what these governors have decreed, but we are proceeding with teaching the Word of God, but we're going to do it in a very deliberate and healthy way, and that's what you did. How was the turnout?
We did that. The turnout was absolutely fantastic. Quite frankly, exactly what we expected, because the people who responded online, letting us know that they were coming, we had thousands of people per service. We had three services over the course of the day. While in our community surrounding us, there were protests, and not too far from us in LA County, riots. And here we were together worshiping and studying the Bible and praising and praying for our state and our governor and our nation. It was a stark contrast. People were filled with hope, excited, and we're going to keep doing it. Graham, I got to tell you, I don't think I'll ever shut the doors to the church again after this.
And you should, right?
No.
Because
correct.
Effectively you're allowing government to crush the First Amendment. I don't care what the courts are saying. I don't care what John Roberts, as misguided as that guy is on the Supreme Court, God bless him, but he's misguided. I don't care what he says. We're allowing these governors to crush First Amendment rights. We're also allowing these governors to control your freedom of religion.
Yeah.
And that's crucial in this country. And I think this is one of the reasons, again, to tie it back to the rioting, I think this is one of the reasons why we're seeing more violence like this, uncontrolled violence in this country, because too many people have lost their religion. Pastor Jack, thank you, and keep us informed of what's going on at your church, okay?
I will, Graham. Thank you.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.